Fruits Basket is a supernatural comedy drama film or anime series. It is about Honda Toru. She's just like a 16, 18-year-old high school girl, and she's homeless. She's supposed to be living with her father's on her father's side grandfather, but his house is being remodeled, so he asks her to stay with a friend while the house is being built, like changed. And Honda Toru is the type of girl, she's very naive, a little bit too selfless. She's the type of person that wouldn't ask her friends and put them on the spot. So she pitches a tent in the wilderness and tries to go to school. However, one day she's found out by the people that own the property, the Somas. There's Shigure Soma. He's painting some rocks when she walks by. And she also finds out that Soma Yuki is also living in the house. He is considered the prince of the school. He's got the very soft voice and feminine looks that people seem to like in the school. So after they find her, she explains her situation, and there's a small landslide that destroys her tent. So they offer her, basically, she can stay with them if she does the cooking and cleaning. It's not a bad deal, so she decides to stay with them until she finds out that the Somas definitely have a sinister secret. Whenever they get stressed or weakened, or they hug a member of the opposite sex, they turn into an animal of the Zodiac. So Shigure, he turns into a dog when he's hugged. Yuki turns into a rat. And the other kid, he is rival, sort of rival to Yuki. His name's Kyo. He turns into a cat, which is not an animal of the Zodiac, but due to legends, he was supposed to be part of the Zodiac. So she's found out their secret, and they're supposed to wipe her memory, but for some reason they don't. The people at the main Soma house, who are in sort of the bosses of everyone, of what they do, decide that it's okay for her to be living there and know their secret. So she has to keep their secret no matter what. What I really liked about this series is that even though it has the weird concept of the animal transformations, that's not the main core of the story. The character is still king in this anime series, and I really enjoy that. Toru is really selfless, but we find out more about her backstory and her upbringing with her mother before her mother died in a car accident. We also get a little bit more character development for Kyon and Yuki as well, why they don't like each other. Also, they only introduced three animals in the first couple episodes, but they'll introduce the other nine characters throughout the series. Sometimes they miss one or two, but really eccentric, hilarious people, good jokes. It's very funny, but it's also very dramatic. And even though the series is mostly dialogue and character development, it's still really interesting to see, you know, where they go introducing new characters and how they stand. And by the time they get to a really crazy emotional ringer for our finale, I definitely was definitely invested in the characters. I really liked it. The animation is not too amazing. It's like basic, but the series can be really funny sometimes. There's like this hostess woman who's like really, really apologetic to the point of like dramatic. Like, lots of weird, funny characters in this. But Fruits Basket is definitely a very enjoyable, easygoing comedy drama. It's got like no, it doesn't really have any action per se. There's like some martial arts fights, but they're not really the core story. It's mostly a drama. It's really well done though, so I definitely recommend Fruits Basket.